Thank you for joining tonight. Good evening. I hope you are warm. And let's wait a couple of minutes and we'll begin.
Fancy seeing you again.
Yes, long time no see.
I'll shut it off.
Thank you, Paul. All right, so I hope that everybody has good speakers tonight. We are going to listen to a lot of music and good music to enjoy. And so thank you for joining, everybody. Let's wait a couple of minutes and then we'll start, okay?
Hello, Elias. Hello.
I'm wondering where Michael and Rona are these days. Are they in the boat? Are they in Boston? Where are they? I don't know.
We're in Brookline.
Oh, cool.
Very, very cool.
Very cool. That's right. So nice to see you.
Nice to see you too.
All right, everybody. So I think we can start. Good evening. And this is the fourth of the media room class that we are doing. Actually the third, I'm sorry. We started with Sephardic music. Last time was classical music and opera, and tonight is Broadway. And we are going to conclude in 2 weeks with the music of Israel. So thank you for joining us. And as you can imagine, I had a very difficult time putting the class tonight together because of the lack of Jewish composers on Broadway. No, it's just the opposite. And actually I had trouble because the trouble was, how much can I teach in an hour and 15 minutes or so about so many people that have been fabulous in the terms of the contributions to the American music life and theater. And so let's begin. I'm going to begin by sharing a PowerPoint presentation, and that includes some audio, and we'll talk about different things. So share sound, and here we go. All right. Very good. So the first question that comes to mind when we are talking about Jewish composers and lyricists from Broadway is why? Why so many? Why so many? So let's see a few of the reasons that the experts, musicologists, and different kind of people put together in terms of why there was, at the beginning of last century, such a huge influence. And here are some of the reasons. So let's begin by reading this out loud. First thing that says here is there was a major migration of Jews to America in the late 19th century, especially to New York City. That's known for everybody, to everybody. The Jewish population in New York City went, listen to this, from about 80,000 in 1980 to 1.6 million in 1920. By 1910, more than 1 million Jews made up 25% of New York's population and made it to the world's largest Jewish city. So just to have in mind, one out of four people in New York City in those days were Jewish. And other reasons are the following that develop into what we know about the contributions of the Jewish musicians from Broadway. Jews trying to assimilate into American life. That makes sense. The entertainment industry was one of the few avenues that were open to Jews, okay? Not every single aspect of life, professions, and other activities were open to the Jewish people and welcome to the Jewish people. And the entertainment was one of the few. Jews were very interested in attending musical theater. And remember the following, for those who who were able to be with me when I taught about the Yiddish theater, remember that we talked about how musical theater was such an important part of the Jewish culture in the Old Country. Old Country meaning Poland, Russia, Eastern Europe. And that developed, started with one of the greatest composers, Abraham Goldfaden, in 1880 in Europe with the Yiddish theater. And the immigrants were bringing that culture of Yiddish theater to America. In the early years of the 20th century, Yiddish theater was thriving, especially for the immigrants. So immigrants would come to America, they wouldn't speak English, or they will try to learn English. In the meantime, they will get entertained by the Yiddish theater. Remember that what we know as the Lower East Side in Manhattan, that was the area where the majority of Jewish people settled, and that was also the area where all the theaters, the Jewish theaters and the Yiddish theater, thrive. The new shows, which integrated songs with stories of everyday Americans in everyday situations, resonated with the children of Jewish immigrants who were aspiring to achieve the American dream. This is more or less like me and my sons. I talk to them about the music in Argentina and they say, ah, and they talk about American music and that's what they like. So it's natural that all these first generation of Americans and musicians were trying to blend into society. Now, let's begin by talking about specifically composers. Let's begin with this guy, Jerome Kern. And Jerome Kern was such an important figure. His name was Jerome David Kern. In 1885, 1945, one of the most important American theater composers of the early 20th century. He wrote more than 700 songs, unbelievable. He used in over 100 stage works, including such classes as Old Man River, Can't Help Loving That Man, A Fine Romance, Smoke Gets in Your Eyes, The Song Is You, Other Things You Are. So I'd like to play with for you Can't Help Loving That Man from Showboat. The picture you see here is from 1927 from the song Old Man River. And it's a great, great song. We'll talk a little bit more after we finish listening to this. Enjoy.
Oh, listen, sister, I love my Mr. Man, and I can't tell you why. There ain't no reason why I should love that must be something that the angels done planned. Fish gotta swim and birds gotta fly. I gotta love one man till I die. Can't help loving that man of mine. Tell me he's lazy, tell me he's slow, tell me crazy, baby, I know. Can't help loving that man of mine. When he goes away, that's a rainy day. And when he comes back, that day is fine. The sun will shine.
Smoking, the roof is leaking in, but he don't seem to
Beautiful. I love this song. It's a great song. A couple of things to say here. Jerome Kern not only was a great composer, perhaps, you know, this is obviously, you know, there are some different sources about this, but Jerome Kern was supposedly the first Jewish composer to put together a show on Broadway. That was in 1913. And the show, the name of the show was The Girl from Utah, 1913. And that was Jerome Kern. Now, you heard a little bit, let's talk about a little bit about music in general. We are coming from an era where the in Europe, the highest level of music was perhaps opera, classical music. Then a composer started to do something a little lighter called operetta. And that was the early transition into the Broadway shows that we know. And you can hear the style of singing that was more related to opera than what we hear in these days. Obviously, that it's more, much more associated with what we call pop music and so on. All right, next composer is Sigmund Rosenberg. And this was not an American-born composer, was a Hungarian-born composer. He's the best known for his musicals and operettas, particularly The Student Prince, 1924, The Desert Song, and The New Moon. Rosenberg was born in Hungary as Sigmund Rosenberg, oh, that's my last name, to a Jewish family, Adam and Clara Rosenberg in Groskanitsa. Let's hear, these are some of the works that he did, and let's hear this beautiful song called Golden Days from The Student Prince, 1924. So as you can hear, these were much more, as I said before, much more associated to what we call as operetta, a light style of opera, where the themes were a little lighter than the drama that we normally hear in operas. And today, you know, this was a show that it was written almost 100 years ago. Today, when we see revivals of this type of music, they are mainly done in places like the Metropolitan Opera of New York. Because of the requirements of the vocal requirements of a trained singer. Now, let's talk about the great and only Irving Berlin. Irving Berlin, born Israel Beilin, or the way it is pronounced, I don't know how. All right, widely considered one of the greatest songwriters in American history, his music forms a great part of the great American songbook. He was born in Russia, and he arrived to the United States at the age of 5. He published his first song, Mary from Sunny Italy, in 1907, receiving 33 cents for the publishing rights. Wow, that was a lot of money. His father was a cantor, and he was an owner of a musical box theater on Broadway. And this is so interesting, such a talented person. And it is commonly believed that Berlin could not read sheet music and was such a limited piano player that he could only play in the key of F sharp using the custom piano equipped with a transposing lever. Unbelievable. I'm sure the experts are right about this, but it's unbelievable to think that he could write such wonderful music. Let's hear from Annie, Get Your Gun. Here is the cover of the CD with Heather Merman. Anything You Can Do.
And now, little lady, if you'll kindly step up to the parapet, I'll give you a lesson in marksmanship.
You couldn't give me a lesson in long-distance spitting. Anything you can do, I can do better. I can do anything better than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Anything you can be, I can be greater. Sooner or later, I'm greater than you.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am. Yes, I am. I can shoot a partridge with a single cartridge.
I can get a sparrow with a bow and arrow.
I can live on bread and cheese.
And only on that?
Yes.
So can a rat.
Any note you can reach, I can go higher.
I can sing anything higher than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
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 No, you can't.
Anything you can buy, I can buy cheaper. I can buy anything cheaper than you.
50 cents?
40 cents.
30 cents?
20 cents.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Anything you can say, I can say softer.
I can say anything softer than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes,
I
can. Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
I can drink my liquor faster than a flicker.
I can do it quicker and get even sicker.
I can open any safe.
Without being caught?
Sure.
That's what I thought, you crook.
Any note you can hold, I can hold longer.
I can hold any note longer than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes,
no, you
can.
Yes, you can.
Fabulous, fabulous song. Let's hear something that it's not that common, that popular, and it's from the show This Is the Army. The song is What the Well-Dressed Men in Harlem Will Wear.
Root zoot booth it out there. Zoot boot as a booth. That shows in the Lennox Avenue clothes. Mr. Dude has disappeared with his flashy tie. You'll see in the Harlem Esquire what the well-dressed man will desire when he's strutting down the street with his sweetie pie. Sun tan, shade of cream, or an olive drab color scheme. That's what the well-dressed man in Harlem will wear. Dress up in O.D. with a tin hat for overseas. That's what the well-dressed man in Harlem will wear. Top hat, white tie and tails, no more. They've been put away till after the war. If you want to know, take a look at Brown Bomber Joe. That's what the well-dressed man in Harlem will wear. About the top hat, white tie and tails, no more. They've been put away till after the war. If you want to know, take a look at Brown Bomber Joe. That's what the well-dressed man in Harlem will wear. Yes, sir! Folks will look and people will stare at what the well-dressed man in Harlem will wear.
The great composer Cole Porter, who wasn't Jewish, famously had once dialogue with Richard Rodgers, and Rodgers and Cole Porter mentioned that he was working on a new show, and Rodgers asked him, so what's going to be the style? And Porter says, I don't know, but I will just write a few Jewish melodies, and that will make it. Interesting enough, although, you know, jokingly, all these composers, all these Jewish composers didn't write Jewish music. It may have sound, you know, in minor keys, in terms of what they were bringing from the old country, but they were actually trying to stay away from that. Irving Berlin famously wrote the song White Christmas, and this song that we just heard, it's clearly just influenced. And so basically they were trying to stay away from, you know, the regular Hanukkah songs or Purim songs or Jewish Yiddish stuff, and get into the American style of music very deeply. A couple of things that I need to mention. One is, if anybody feels like sharing any thoughts or even questions in the chat, feel free to do it. And also, the other thing is that for those who are here who are experts, I'm sure that some people will be upset because I couldn't include everybody. And there are so many composers that I had to leave out of this class, and it's impossible to do it in 1 hour, just to clarify. All right, very good. Let's go now into the great George Gershwin, and born Jacob Bruskin Gershowitz. That was his real name. He was, as you know, very successful in popular music, writing many of the shows with his brother, Ira, as well as in the classical field with several concerts, works, and an opera that have become standards in the contemporary repertoire. That is obviously Porgy and Bess. Born in Brookline in New York City in 1898, the son of Rose and Morris Gershowitz, immigrants from Russia. And let's hear a couple of songs. The first one that I want to play, it's Clap Your Hands. That comes from the show name OK.
Come on, you children, gather around, you children, and we will lose that evil spirit called a voodoo. Nothing but trouble if he is found, you children, but you can chase the hoodoo with the dance that you do. Let me lead the way, Jubilee today, hey. He'll never hound you, stamp on the ground, you children. Come on, clap your hand, slap of your thigh. Hallelujah, hallelujah, everybody come along and join the jubilee. Clap of your hand, slap of your thigh. Don't you lose time, don't you lose time. Come along and shake your shoes. Time now for you and me. On the sands of time, you are only a pebble. Remember, trouble must be treated just like a rebel. Send him to the devil. Clap of your hand, slap of your thigh. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Everybody come along and join the jubilee. Everybody come along and join the jubilee.
Beautiful song. I want to talk briefly about something that perhaps some people who heard me singing one of the songs heard me saying before. In this Porgy and Bess, the show that it's here that mentions that it's kind of like an opera, there is one famous song called It Ain't Necessarily So. And that song sounds very similar to the Torah blessings that we recite every time we chant the Torah. It ain't necessarily so. Baruch et Adonai ameborach. All right. And many times, you know, people talk about, musicologists, experts talk about that. One of the stories that surrounds the composition between George and Ira related to the music is that it seems like when they were practicing for their bar mitzvah, they had a tutor who made them crazy. He was impossible, and he made the Gershwin brothers, you know, crazy. And he would ask all the time, George, Ira, repeat after me. And then they decided to write this song using that type of the melody. Hopefully it's a, you know, true story. We don't know that, but it was worth to tell you that. Now, another composer, Frederick Lowy. And here you can see Audrey Hepburn at the bottom, My Fair Lady. He was an Austrian-American composer. He collaborated with Alan J. Lerner on a series of Broadway musicals, including Brigadoon, Paint Your Wagon, My Fair Lady. That's perhaps one of the most known ones. And so listen to this. We are going to hear the great two Jewish composers, Lowe and Lerner, writing Get Me to the Church on Time.
Show how you'll miss me, but get me to the church on time. If I am dancing, pull up the floor. If I am whistling, meet me at the door. Oh, I'm getting married in the morning. Ding dong, the bells are gonna chime. Pick up a rumpus, but don't lose the compass, and get me to the church. Get me to the church, for God's sakes, get me to the church on time. I'm getting married in the morning. Ding dong, the bells are gonna chime. Drag me or jail me, stamp me and nail me, but get me to the church on time. I gotta be there in the morning, screw stamp and look in me prime. Some bloke who's able, lift up the table and get me to the church on time. If I am flying, then shoot me down. If I am going, get out of town. For I'm getting married in the morning. Ding dong, the bells are gonna chime. Feather and Tommy, call out the army, but get me to the church.
Get me to the church.
For God's sakes, get me to the church on time.
I thought they were going to throw once in a while, get me to Minyan on time. Anyways, but no. And this is a clear example of, you know, the Jewish composers trying to blend into society, into the American culture through the music. Now, let's talk about the great Richard Rodgers. Richard Rodgers of the Rodgers and Hammerstein. 43 Broadway musicals and over 900 songs. We thought that Jerome Kern wrote 700. That was impressive. Look at this, 900 songs to his credit. Rodgers was one of the most significant American composers of the 20th century, and his compositions had a significant impact on popular music. He's best known for his songwriting partnerships with lyricist Lawrence Hart, also Jewish, with whom he wrote many musicals through the 1920s and 30s, including... Yes, there are some shows here, and yes, very good. Now, he also wrote many shows with Hammerstein, Oscar Hammerstein. Here it is. And Oscar Hammerstein, I'm sorry I missed that. And he perhaps wrote with him the most popular ones, you know, Oklahoma, Carousel, South Pacific, The Gideon Ike, Sound of Music. Now, this is interesting to notice. In the third paragraph, Rodgers was the first person to win all of what we are considered the top American entertainment awards in theater, film, recording, and television. A Tony, an Oscar, a Grammy, and an Emmy, known collectively as an EGOT. And in addition, he also got a Pulitzer Prize. Now, let's listen to some music, the famous and gorgeous song from Carousel, You Never Walk Alone.
When you walk through a storm, chin up high. Know that one?
And don't be afraid of the dark. At the end of the storm is a golden sky and the sweet silver song of the
This is such a gorgeous song, and the lyrics are so beautiful. I have to say, this is a personal thing. For those who know me, I'm a big soccer fan, soccer the sport, actually the actual football, that is actually my sport, because you play with the feet. No, just kidding. And it's so funny for me, because sometimes I watch British soccer, and there is one team called Liverpool, from the Liverpool City. And before every match, and before COVID, all the fans in the stands will sing You'll Never Walk Alone. That's their song, That's the song that Liverpool fans sing every time before the match. Interesting. And fabulous how, you know, music transcends countries and styles and sports and whatever you want to describe. So let's listen to a little bit of I Have Dream. This is come from The King and I. And I believe that this is Yul Brynner, the famous actor of the Ten Commandments, who was the Pharaoh. Gorgeous music. Let's talk now about Kurt Vile. Kurt Vile is perhaps not so well known in terms of as a composer. Let's talk about a little bit about him. Let's read about him. He was German, active from the 1920s in his native country, and in his later years in the United States. He was a leading composer for the stage who was best known for his fruitful collaborations with Bertolt Brecht. He developed productions such as his best-known work, the Threepenny Opera, which included the ballad Mack the Knife. And he became a United States citizen in 1943. Let's listen from Lady in the Dark, Girl of the Moon. Great song.
Flights of fancy,
your image I drew.
I look at you and can see
that fancy come true. Oh, girl of the moment, with the light in your eyes, and the sun in your hair, and the rose in your cheeks, and the love in your voice. Oh, girl of the moment, you're my moment every time.
What do you think of the state of the theater?
Can I have a job? I love it, otherwise it stinks.
What about your rivalry with Marlene Dietrich?
Oh, please, there is no rivalry between me and Miss No Talent.
Oh, girl of the moment, with the light in your eyes, and the sun in your hair, and the rose in your cheeks, and the laugh in your voice. Oh, girl of the moment, you're my moment every time.
One thing to notice about Kurt Vile is all the composers that we previously heard were either immigrants or son of immigrants who came to America at the beginning of the century. And it wasn't the case with Kurt Weill. He was in Germany. He had to escape Germany because of the Holocaust. He was first banned because his music was too liberal for the Nazis. And it's part of the category of the composers, Jewish composers, who were described as degenerated music. So he had to escape. He came to America. And later, obviously, he was able to develop a career here and with many successful shows. Frank Loesser, the great composer and lyricist, was born Francis Henry Loesser in New York, the son of Henry Loesser, a pianist, and Julia Enrich, American songwriter who wrote the music and lyrics for the Broadway musicals Guys and Dolls, How to Succeed in Business with Really Trying, and other. He won separate Tony Awards for the music and lyrics in both shows, as well as shared the Pulitzer Prize for drama for the latter. He also wrote songs for Hollywood films, 60, only 60. Anyway, so let's hear this beautiful song from Guys and Dolls called I've Never Been in Love Before by Frank Loesser.
I've never been in love before. Now all at once it's you forevermore. I've never been in love before. I thought my heart was safe. I thought I knew the score. But this is wine that's all too strange and strong. I'm full of foolish song. Out my song must mourn. So please forgive this helpless haze I'm in. I've really never been in love before.
I've never been in love before. It's you forevermore. I've never been in love before. I thought my heart was safe. I thought I knew the score. But this is why that's all too strange and strong. I'm full of foolish song. And out my song must pour.
So please forgive this helpless haze I'm in. I've really never been.
Our next composer is Leonard Bernstein, and there is not much we need to say about him. And how about if, while I'm playing Make Our Garden Grow, you can read a little bit about his bio?
No, we won't think noble because we're not noble. We won't live in beautiful harmony because there's no such thing in this world, nor should there be. We promise only to do our best and live out our lives. Dear God, that's all we can promise in truth. Marry me, Cunegonde.
You've been a fool, and so have I, but come and be my wife. And let us try before we die to make some sense of life. We're neither pure nor wise nor good. We'll do the best we know. We'll build our house
and chop our wood and make our garden grow and make our garden grow.
I thought the world was sugar cake, for so our master said, but now I'll teach my hands to bake our loaf of daily bread.
Remember of your flesh of God,
we'll do the best we know.
We'll build our house and chop.
Such a beautiful music. It's such a great song, and I always get goosebumps by listening to this. Our next composer is Charles Strauss, and he was born in 1928 and born in New York City to Jewish parents. We are going to hear this beautiful song. He's the composer of Annie, Bye Bye Birdie, so many other wonderful shows. Let's listen to Charles Strauss himself singing this song, Once Upon a Time, from All American.
This next song is from a musical called All American that I wrote with Mel Brooks and Lee Adams.
Once upon a time, a girl with moonlight in her eyes put her hand in mine and said she loved me so. But that was once upon a time, very long ago. Once upon a hill, we sat beneath a willow tree, counting all the stars and waiting for the dawn. But that was once upon a time, now the tree is gone. How the breeze ruffled through her hair, how we always laughed as though tomorrow weren't there. We were young and didn't have a care. Where did we go? upon a time, the world was sweeter than we knew. Everything was ours, how happy we were then. But somehow, once upon a time, never comes again.
Just to clarify that we are working, we are hearing Jewish composers and lyricists on Broadway, and there are so many different aspects of putting together a Broadway show that I'm not covering tonight. I'm not talking about Jewish choreographers, I'm not talking about Jewish singers, and so on. I mean, the list could never end with the contributions that the Jewish people have made to Broadway. The next composer is not other than the composer of Fiddler on the Roof, Jerry Bock. But I want to bring you some unusual stuff here. He wrote a few years later than he wrote Fiddler on the Roof, this show called The Rothschilds. And I'd like to play a couple of songs for you about this beautiful show.
Shoulders back, every head held high, for at last we're underway. Founders of the famous financial firm Rothschild and Sons. Jaws will drop when the world finds out what a step we took today. Copenhagen's favorite banking house, Rothschild and Sons. Yes, you skeptical souls who sold us short. We're superior agents of the court. Twinkling high in the fiscal sky is a newly risen star. There's another firm in the firmament, Rothschild and Sons. Stands ready to satisfy an expanding clientele. Servants of a prince and a king so far, Rothschild and Sons. Who's at home in the gilded halls where the reigning blue bloods dwell? Members of a firm whose initials are Rothschild and Sons. We're superior agents of the court. International finance is our fort. Say hello to a bright new world, to a bleak one say farewell. Look who's making loans to the Danish crown. Look who gave a shove and a wolf and Joshua. Look who's making loans, Rothschild and Sons.
I recommend, actually, if you want to hear this show, it's the music is really beautiful, and it's about the famous Rothschild and the family. Obviously, this show wasn't as successful as Fiddler on the Roof. Now, speaking about Fiddler on the Roof, this is just a gem that I'd like to play for you. You know, you are very familiar with the song Shabbat Prayer, that it's in the Fiddler on the Roof. May the Lord protect and defend you. Okay. This is the earlier version that Jerry Bock wrote, but Jerry Bock, the composer, talks a little bit at the beginning of this song why he wrote what he wrote. And this is such a beautiful thing. Pay attention to what he says here.
Shall this theme, maybe Tevye's theme, whatever that is, or may not. It's got a certain Yiddish-Russian quality. It's overly sad, which might be a point of humor. On the other hand, it could also be legitimately sad, which might be more poignant than humorous. And here it is.
Ba 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 ba
This is such a fabulous, as I said before, is a gem. And I'm so glad that when they do these days, this re-edition of the shows or any type of music, they include extra bonus tracks. And this is one of the one that they added. It's always fascinating to hear, you know, each composer works differently. To some, the melody comes naturally, and to some, they go by more music theory. And this idea of having the early version of it, it's really fabulous, really beautiful. So we talk about some collaborations that some lyricists did, and let's talk about, let me show you a little bit who we are talking about. So here on the left, this is Lawrence Hart. All of these are Jewish, obviously. And he did many collaborations with Richard Rodgers, and he wrote, for example, Blue Moon. Blue Moon, Ira Gershwin here is in picture with George Gershwin. And he not only wrote music with George Gershwin, but actually Ira had a very long life and George had a very short life. So after George passed away, he did more collaborations with Jerome Kern and Kurt Weill, the composers that we heard before. Here at the bottom, we have Oscar Hammerstein II. He did also collaborations with Richard Rodgers and Jerome Kern, writing many of the famous lyrics. Here on the top is Alan J. Lerner with Frederick Lowe. This is the guy who wrote Take Me to the Church on Time, and among many others. We cannot forget the great duo Adolph Green and Betty Comen, who wrote many, many wonderful lyrics and shows, like with Bernstein, they did collaborations on The Town, Wonderful Town. And Sheldon Harnick was the guy who put all the lyrics to the beautiful songs of Fiddler on the Roof. Here we have him on the left and Jerry Bock, the composer we just heard, on the left, on the right. Let's talk about Stephen Sondheim. And he's still alive. He's born in 1930, and he wrote many wonderful shows. How about you read about this composer one at the same time that we hear Being Alive, a great song that comes from the show Company.
What do you get? Someone to hold you too close. Someone to hurt you too deep. Someone to sit in your chair to ruin your sleep.
That's true, but there's more than that.
Is that all you think there is to it?
You you've got so many reasons for not being with someone, but Robert, you haven't one good reason for being alone.
Come on, you're onto something, Bobby. You're onto something.
Someone to need you too much. Someone to know you too well. Someone to pull you up short, to put you through hell.
You see what you look for, you know.
You're not a kid anymore, Robbie. I don't think you'll ever be a kid again, kiddo.
Hey, buddy, don't be afraid that it won't be perfect. The only thing to be afraid of really is that it won't be.
Don't stop now. Keep going.
Someone you have to let in. Someone whose feelings you spare. Someone who, like it or not, will want you to share a little, a lot.
And what does all that mean?
Robert, how do you know so much about it when you've never been there?
It's much better living it than looking at it, Robert.
Add him up, Bobby, add him up.
Someone to crowd you with love. Someone to force you to care. Someone to make you come through. Will always be there, as frightened as you of being alive. Being alive. Being alive. Being alive.
Blow out the candles, Robert, and make a...
So I just wanted to show you, obviously, Stephen Sondheim, fabulous composer. This show is from 1970, and the first shows we started hearing were from 1920s. And how different the music it is, but also how different the style of singing is. The first ones were much more related to the operettas, and this is much more like talking and much more like pop music and you know, like... closer to what we hear these days. Another great composer was Jerry Herman, and he wrote many, many wonderful shows like Hello Dolly that we are going to do here at Temple Emmanuel. We were planning to do this in January, but we couldn't because of the COVID, but a year from now we'll do it. And let's listen to this famous song, I Am What I Am. Thank you. Yes, such a beautiful song. A couple of things. This song has been translated into so many different languages because of its message. And one of the things that was important, that it's important to notice about Jerry Herman, is that he wrote not only the music, but the lyrics of his shows, which is actually super impressive. Next, it's Marvin Hamlisch. And he wrote a couple of fabulous, well-known shows. And the American composer and conductor. Years ago, Cantors, we don't have anything else to do, and we get together once a year for a Cantors convention. And thanks to one Cantor who knew him, Marvin Hamlisch was there with us in the convention, and he did a show of his music. It was such a remarkable time. I'll never forget that. So he wrote, obviously, Funny Girl, The Chorus Line, and I'd like to play one song that it's from the show. They are playing our song. It's actually the same title of the song as the show.
Oh, they're playing my song. Oh, yeah, they're playing my song. And then they're playing my song. Everybody's gotta say a word now, listen to that sweet melody. I'm happy to say, in my own humble way, every perfect note of that was written by me. Oh, they're playing my song, that table's humming along, that couple half out the door is coming back to hear more of my music. At first I thought this place was a dive, I chose it in haste, but they sure they got taste. As long as they're playing my song. Who would have known 9 months ago that I would give birth at my piano? In all honesty, I've got to admit, I knew this song would be an international hit. Ho ho, they're playing my tune, too bad it's ending so soon. But when we all got to go, it's good to know that they'll be playing. Oh God, I'm praying. Playing my soul.
Great song. If you wanna get to know more about all these composers, obviously you can Google them or you can go on YouTube. But one documentary that I recommend is the one that a few years ago PBS did about Jewish composers on Broadway, and it's fantastic because not only they show and they play all this music, but also some of the composers talk about their creations. Our next one is Stephen Schwartz. Stephen Schwartz, born in 1948, and he wrote many wonderful shows like Godspell, Pippin, and Wicked. Actually, Wicked, very contemporary and actually very successful on Broadway. I'm going to play Corner of the Sky from Pippin, thanks to my dear friend Brian. Thank you for giving me the music of this show. And a great song. Let's listen to it.
Every man has his daydream. dreams, every man has his goal. People like the way dreams have of sticking to the soul. Thunderclouds have their lightning, nightingales have their song. And don't you see, I want my life to be something more than long. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky. So many men seem destined to settle for something small, but I won't rest until I know I'll have it all. So don't ask where I'm going, just listen when I've gone. And far away you'll hear me singing softly to the dawn. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my
sky. Beautiful, really beautiful. As you can see here in the bio of Stephen Schwartz, one of the things that it's important to notice that he wrote the music of Prince of Egypt. And one of the, you know, it was obviously talking about the story of Pesach, of Passover. One of the songs that it's very known, very well known from that show is "There Can Be Miracles When You Believe." It's a great song. Alan Menken, obviously a great composer. He wrote the scores for many movies and shows. You can hear, you can see here all these fabulous compositions he has done. Here on the left, you can see Little Shop of Horrors. And interesting enough, I have great memories of this show because my son Mikey played the dentist of this show in Schechter in Hebrew, all in Hebrew. And it was fabulous. Let's listen from The Beauty and the Beast, A Home.
Yes, I made the choice. For Papa, I will stay. But I don't deserve to lose my freedom in this way, you monster. If you think that what you've done is right, well then, you're a fool. Think again. Is this home? Is this where I should learn to be happy? Never dreamed that a home could be dark and cold. I was told every day in my childhood, even when we grow old, heart's far, far away. Home is too. Is this home? Is this what I must learn to believe in? Try to find some. something good in this tragic place. Just in case I should stay here forever, held in this empty space. Oh, but that won't be easy. I know the reason why my heart's far, far away. Home's a lie. What I'd give to return to the life that I knew lately, but I know.
So the last three composers I want to share with you, we don't have time to play them all, but just for you to know, the great composer of Man of La Mancha is Mitch Licht, The Impossible Dream, the famous song. And Frank Wildrum, he did Jekyll and Hyde. This is the moment at the bottom. And I want to end with Les Mis, such a fabulous show, one of my favorite shows of all time. The composer, Claude-Michel Schoenberg, it's French and is Jewish, and he wrote music like this. And do you hear the people sing?
Do you hear the people sing, singing the song of angry men? It is the music of a people who will not be slaves again. When the beating of your heart echoes the beating of the drums, there is a life about to start when tomorrow comes.
Will you join in our crusade? Who will be strong and stand with me? Beyond the barricade, is there a world you long to see?
Then join in the fight that will give you the right to be free.
Do you hear the people sing?
Some will fall and some will live. Will you stand up and take your chance? The blood of the martyrs will water the meadows of France.
Do you hear the people sing? Singing the song of angry men. It is the music of a people who will not be slaves again. When the beating of your heart echoes the beating of the drums, there is a life about to start.
Beautiful, beautiful music, so much music and so much information to share and to learn about this composer. A little bit of advertising here. Our fabulous Cole Emmanuel, Temple Emmanuel choir, adult choir, at the end of the year in June, they gave me a wonderful gift, which is a year subscription to Broadway.com, which is a wonderful website where you can watch, you know, any kind of show you want. So it has been a great addition to our family. My son David, who loves theater, and I watch it all the time. So if you have time, it's perfect to do it from the couch in your home. And So this was the idea. The idea was to show you the amazing contributions that the Jewish people have made into American society and American music. Obviously, again, this is not an absolute list of composers, neither lyricists, and by no means this means to be something of an expertise. But I wanted to show, you know, what I thought it could be interesting to all of you. And thank you everybody for sharing, for staying with me up to late night. And I see some of the comments. Yes, and some of you may be absolutely right in everything you say. And yes, Hal Linden and Gloria Gaynor, some of you are mentioning some of this stuff, and actually, yes, obviously talking about Dorothy Fields. Yes, Dorothy Fields appeared in the Annie Get Your Gun when I showed a little bit of the cover of the CD. She wrote the lyrics, and she also wrote so many others. And thank you everybody for joining tonight. I hope you enjoy it.